Hey guys, welcome back to Mommying Unconventionally. For those who don't know me, I am Tasha, and I have a special surprise for all of you today. So as promised, I am taking your traditional Thanksgiving dishes and I am spinning them, twisting them, mixing them all up, and coming up with the most creative dishes that you can surprise and wow your guests with. So these are going to be great dishes for dinner parties, Friendsgiving, or your actual Thanksgiving. So stay tuned for the next two videos. I'm gonna do a three-part series on IGTV. This is the first video that I'm gonna be doing, and then I'm gonna be doing one video per week leading up to Thanksgiving. So I am super excited. You're gonna get three amazing recipes from me. On top of that, you're going to get a couple of little sprinkle of reels in the mix with maybe some cocktails or a mocktail. I'm gonna surprise you each week with something new. So I'm really excited to show you what I'm gonna be cooking with today. So the theme today is going to be turkey. That is the highlight of Thanksgiving, right? That's the main course. That's the grand dish at Thanksgiving. So we are going to use it as an appetizer though. So instead of taking it from, we're going to take it from being the main course to now being the first course, the appetizer. And we're going to do meatballs. So it's a turkey meatball. We're going to use some ground turkey, but this is how we're going to add our little twist to it, right? So ground turkey, we are going to season it like dressing. So we are going to add lots and lots of sage in there. We're going to add some cornbread crumbs, some celery, some onion, and we're going to give it that real good flavor that you would taste in your dressing or your stuffing. And we're going to put that in the meatball. It's going to be amazing. But then we're going to kick it up a notch even more, and we are going to add a cranberry orange glaze. So how many of y'all love a good cranberry sauce? I do. So we are actually going to take the canned jelly cranberry that we all love and hold dear to our hearts. We're going to take that and we're going to turn it into a glaze with some orange juice and some brown sugar. And that's gonna be a nice little sauce that you can kind of baste over your turkey, or you can just dip it, however you wanna do it, but it's gonna taste absolutely delicious. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna go over the ingredients as I usually do, and then I'm gonna get to work and y'all can just follow along. So for the meatball, you need ground turkey, you need the leaves from the celery stalk, and then you need one celery stalk, half of an onion. We're going to mince the onion and we're going to get the celery as fine as possible. One egg, some cornbread crumbs. So this, the way that you can get this is take the bag. Let me show you. Take the cornbread bag for your stuffing and you're going to take about a cup of it and you're going to put it in a Ziploc bag. And you're gonna hammer away at it until you get these fine crumbs, okay? So that's how you're gonna get the cornbread crumbs. You might need chicken stock, so just keep it on standby. It depends on how dry your turkey is, and then if it seems a little dry, you're gonna add some liquid to loosen it up a little bit. For your seasonings, salt, pepper, poultry seasoning, and of course the sage. That's what really gives it that dressing flavor. So we're gonna work on the meatball. You're gonna need some cooking spray because you're gonna wanna spray your baking rack with cooking spray. And you're gonna wanna set your preset your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. For the cranberry glaze, the cranberry orange glaze, you're going to need one can of the jellied cranberry sauce, one cup of fresh orange juice, and one cup of brown sugar, light or dark, your choice. You can mix them both up if you'd like. That is all the ingredients. Let's go ahead and get started.
Doo-doo-doo.
Okay, so this is where you kind of want to get in here with your hands, mix everything really, really good. I forgot to mention before, I used 1 pound of ground turkey, which is going to yield roughly about 24 meatballs. If you need more, just double the recipe. We're going to make 1-inch meatballs. So take a little bit of your turkey, roll it. And also I'm using 93% lean ground turkey, 7% fat. You want your meatball to be about 1 inch in roundness. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead, make a few more of these, put them on my oven rack, and go ahead and throw them in the, put them on my baking rack over a cookie sheet, and go ahead and put it in the oven at 400 degrees. These will probably take about 30 to 40 minutes, depending on how many meatballs, probably more on the 30 minute end. It looks like I don't need to add any of the chicken stock because these are actually as moist as I would like them to be. All right, let's go ahead and get these in the oven. Once you get everything mixed well, you're going to want to turn your heat on high and bring the sauce to a boil. Once it boils, turn it down to a simmer and simmer on low for about 10 minutes until it's a glaze-like consistency.